Yeah.
Sorry, I couldn't wait for your call. Oh. So you decided to tell Nicholas.
Tell me what?
I put together a day of pampering at the Metro Court Spa for Elizabeth. You know, to rejuvenate the soul, renew the spirit. Who could use it more than her? But in order for that to happen, arrangements need to be made for Cam and Aiden. I just assumed she would go to you about that, not some other candidate like Lucky.
Nicholas was just giving me a ride home. I haven't spoken to him about anything yet.
No, it's no problem. I agree with Max. You should take a day for yourself. But Cam and Aiden are fine at Windermere. Spencer loves having them there. You should go.
Thanks. I'll let you know.
Okay.
Talk to you soon.
All right.
Hi.
Bye.
Okay, obviously you did not tell Nicholas, but you told Lucky already, right?
No, neither of them know.
But you said you were going to.
I know what I said, and I went over to Lucky's and had every intention of telling him the truth, but I couldn't.
What stopped you?
He's in so much pain over losing his son and dealing with the fact that it's his dad who's responsible. And then he said something about hitting the bottle with his dad, and
he's not using again, is he?
No, he's not, because of his brother. He said if it weren't for Nicholas, he'd be in worse shape, and then he was so glad he had his brother to lean on.
Elizabeth, that makes it even more important that Lucky and Nicholas know the truth.
Nicholas is keeping Lucky's head above water. If I tell them the truth, it'll blow them apart. I will not take Nicholas away from Lucky.
Just don't know what level my concern should be. I mean, it could mean anything. You could have a broken nail. You could have a dead body in the kitchen, for all I know.
Okay, first, let me tell you that this is not my fault. I did not ask to be involved in this. I didn't want to get involved in anybody else's mess. I was just trying to do a good deed.
All right. Is there a medical emergency? Because if there is, time is of the essence.
Don't be silly. That's... This is much, much worse.
Worse?
Of all the people I would be put in the position to keep a secret for. Elizabeth! And not some mundane secret either. No, this is like a rip-roaring, throw a bunch of people's lives on the fire kind of secret. I mean, would it be too much to ask for Elizabeth to tell her own truth and let me off the hook?
There's no...
Wait, are you confused?
No, I got this. So far, I've got Elizabeth and a secret that you would resent being privy to. Maybe it'd help if you just kept going just a little bit longer.
I really want to tell you. I really do. Because you are a practical person. And you'll be able to tell me what to do. Like, do I keep Elizabeth's secret? And for how long? 2 days? Indefinitely? What about the people that this secret affects? Is it my job to tell them? Is it bad karma to force a grieving mother to do it, even though it is Elizabeth? Or is the karma going to hit from the other end? Are you going to break up with me?
What? How did you get there?
I'm keeping something really big from you.
Okay, does it have to do with us?
No.
And are you exercising admirable restraint when clearly it's just bursting out of you?
What the? Admirable restraint? Yeah, I am. Wow, who would have thought? I could really use your advice on this, though.
Okay, so look, I don't need to know what Elizabeth's secret is in order to tell you that your impulse to keep your mouth shut, follow it. Stick with that. Let Elizabeth deal with whatever problem she's got.
You and Maxie work.